You brought back Ralph Rumble. What brought that song back?
Nothing there, just, I was into sort of,
inspiration.
Yeah, I was playing Link Gray a lot, and, playing Rumble and that, you know, mm-hmm. Link Gray, which is fucking one of the greatest songs ever made, and when I play it, I would play it about 5 times.
What's that?
Rumble by Link Gray. Mm-hmm. Which made me sort of thinking, so I got roped from around and played that, and it sounded really good. I was surprised how good it was. It's not a good idea to do it, because it's like we don't write material like that anymore.
Yeah.
You know, it's like a sort of calling the process or something.
Mm.
It's sort of odd. And I think a lot of our audience now probably don't know how to do it. It's just, you know, you're talking about 6 years ago, aren't you?
Right, yeah.
But I also, it's just down there, I always try and get in the studio, you know. I try and, sometimes there's a lot missing. Sometimes if you get, like, really super duper PAs, you know, it's so clean, it's horrible, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so you're sort of at the mercy of those people. So I thought, if you've got a loud head, sometimes it's strange because this has got it, I've never had to use it, you know, because of a PAs. But that was the idea, you know, like in the studio, I like put a lot of vocals through cabs. I think it sounds really good.
Is the LP selling well here on the PB?
Probably, but it's doing great.
Mm-hmm.
It's perfectly done about 10,000. Strange thing, it just shows you, doesn't it? You don't expect my cruise cream. Nobody wanted to release that as a single because it's 6 minutes long, you know. Most cities, we're playing in Britain like that now, you know, we're finding we're going to we'll have to hit real small clubs, like 500 cap, you know. Well, you see, this is the trick that I sort of learned, you know, like, this is good PR, you see. It's deliberate policy. It's like how New Milan and that get good. They play the marquee for 2 nights. And of course, 800 people turn up each night, so 300 people are locked down. And everybody goes, oh, you know, it's real happening.
Did you hear that?
Which I think is really, like, bad manners. Because remember, the people always say that, like, you make out you fucking bunch of old fogies. You know, people forget that. I don't think it took us about a year and a half to get a fucking drummer, it took us about 2 years to get our bloody first record out, you know, things like that. We used to play like once every fucking 3 months, you know, things like that. And we were all about 16, 17, well, I wasn't, but I was 31. Thank you.